So the key images are your handle of malleus and long process of incus, neck of malleus, and the lenticular process, incudosteptial joint. This is the malleo-incudal joint, this particular gap, and the classic ice cream cone appearance. These four images, you can see it in every single temporal bone. So you zoom it on one side, you go through the, scroll through it, you will be able to see it every time. So that is good enough for you to say the ossicular chain is intact. Let's go a little bit into the middle ear and then try and appreciate few more, little bit of revision. So we know that long process of incus is coming here. This is the body of incus, short process is going posteriorly into the attic. Here is the long process of incus, and then it comes and bends a little bit and ends in a small tiny nodular area called the lentiform nodule, also known as lentiform process. Okay, and then it articulates with the stapes. The stapes, so that forms the incudosteptial joint. So the stapes has got a few, there is a head of stapes, there is a neck of stapes, and there is an anterior crest and a posterior crest. So together this is called stapes superstructure. So depending upon the article you read, suddenly they'll say stapes superstructure. You don't know what it is. It's basically everything you see there. And the foot plate is different. That is why they want to differentiate that from the stapes superstructure. And then comes the foot plate, which articulates with oval window, and there is an annular membrane there, and that forms the stapedio-vestibular joint. Okay. So now comes to the middle ear blind areas, which means the otoscopy, the surgeon will not be able to see. There are two important recesses which we need to comment on in our every report. The one is the sinus tympani. Sinus tympani is located here on the posterior wall. So you look at this, what is called the W-shaped configuration of the posterior wall at the same level as the stapes. You will see this particular recess is called the sinus tympani. Sometimes the ENT surgeons write it as ST cholestotoma. That means they wanted to exclude a sinus tympanic cholestotoma. So basically you want to look for an ossicular chain, a soft tissue, and a soft tissue which is hiding there. If you think cholestotoma due to other reasons, any soft tissue here has to be cholestotoma unless proven otherwise. And then you get this top, the pyramid-like projection is called the pyramidal eminence. And then you've got a little recess here, is the facial recess, because there is just posterior to it, you see the descending mastoid part of the facial nerve. So facial nerve, pyramidal recess. The pyramidal eminence or the facial recess, these areas are quite important because the pyramidal eminence actually has got a tunnel. Inside that tunnel, there is a stapedius muscle, and this muscle actually gives rise to a little tendon, which is very, very fine hair-like tendon, which comes out of the tip of the pyramidal eminence and attaches to the neck of the stapes. Okay, so that is the stapedius muscle which comes there, and there is a tensor tympani muscle comes in this area. If you can able to appreciate my imagination that there is a little bit is going there, a small tendon fiber, I just widen the window. If you can appreciate it better now, maybe you can see that there's a little bit of thin tendon fiber which is going there and attaching to the neck of the malleus. This is the tensor tympani, and anteriorly you see the tensor tympani canal, which is filled with the muscle attenuation, which is little bit above the level of the carotid canal. And you can see this is the tensor tympani canal, and this comes out here and turns 90 degrees and goes and attaches to the this neck of the malleus. So there is a stapedius, you can see this thin wisp going anteriorly. This is the stapedius tendon, and this is the tensor tympani tendon. But the blind areas are here. This is the anterior epitympanic recess, that is another blind area, and this is the sinus tympani.